Seven aid workers killed in an Israeli airstrike in central Gaza. They include citizens from Australia, Britain, and Poland. The seven workers of the nonprofit World Central Kitchen, who also included Palestinians and a U.S. and Canadian dual citizen, were traveling in two armored cars. Despite coordinating their movements with the Israeli Defense Force, the convoy was hit as it was leaving an aid facility. They had just dropped off more than 100 tons of aid brought to Gaza by Z. Now the Central Workers Kitchen condemned the attack, calling it unforgivable. Australia demanding accountability from Israel.
Australia expects full accountability for the deaths of aid workers, which is completely unacceptable. Aid workers and those doing humanitarian work, and indeed all innocent civilians, need to be provided with protection. Australia has had a very clear position of supporting a sustainable ceasefire, of calling for it for some period of time, of calling for humanitarian aid to go to the people of Gaza who are suffering from this deprivation, to make sure that hostages are released as well.
The Israeli military, for its part, said it is conducting a thorough review into the tragic incident. A former spokesperson of President Rodrigo Duterte says the former president never entered into a so-called gentleman's agreement with China over the Ayungin Shoal. Attorney Salvador Panelo says he talked to Duterte about it and he denied forging a deal with China. Panelo adds whoever made the claim only wants publicity. It was another former Duterte spokesman, Attorney Harry Roque, who revealed the deal. Roque said Panelo is correct because the agreement was not specific to Ayungin Shoal.
The gentleman's agreement is to respect the status quo on the entire West Philippine Sea dispute. Mm-hmm. So that is correct. I do not deny that. And that is why I am, in fact, surprised that what has been coming out in the media is a sellout of sorts.
Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro demanding accountability for that supposed gentleman's agreement. But he says the country must also not lose sight of China's illegal activities in the West Philippine Sea. China has repeatedly cited the alleged deal to put the blame on the Philippines over the worsening tension in the West Philippine Sea. But Teodoro claims Beijing is using the deal to refocus the debate away from their illegal activities in the disputed waterway.
Our numbers that matter today. Philippine factory gate prices contracting for the second straight month in February. The producer price index posted a 1.2% decline for the said month. The Statistics Bureau said the manufacturer of computer, electronics, and optical products drove the downtrend in the annual rate of producer prices. Other contributors were the lower manufacturer of food products and beverages. Among 19 industry divisions, officials say 14 showed annual decreases in February, while only 5 saw annual increases. An executive of Vismin developer Cebu Landmasters expects the company to log the same growth momentum for this year. Cebu Landmasters CFO Grant Cheng told ANC the challenge is to not grow too fast, but to grow sustainably. He also teased an upcoming project, their first foray in Luzon.
We're looking at around 12 projects this year. We're expanding into new markets like One and General Santos. And we haven't been shy in saying that we have an eye towards expanding in Luzon. We're engaged with certain landowners so that we could start making inquiries and, in fact, making moves towards acquisitions and developments there. The total value of those 12 projects should be north of 20 billion. Talks are serious. The intention is there. We've put in time and resources to explore some very serious and, frankly, some very exciting opportunities. We'll probably raise some eyebrows when they find out who exactly we're going to partner with and where. Hopefully an announcement this year.